Welcome back to my channel. Today I am filming a review video on the BECCA APRES Glow Palette. Let's just call it the ASG face palette. And this came out for holiday 2017. Now this has been out for a while and I refused to buy this thing when it first came out. I was like, no thank you, $54. It looks just like the Jaclyn Hill palette if you ask me. And I was just like, nope, 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 nope. So I bet you guys are wondering how I ended up with this palette. So if you are interested, just keep watching. Now, if you are new, welcome. My name is Karen Harris. I upload every other day, so you do get quite a bit of content from me. I am so excited for you guys to join me on this video. If you do find this video useful, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe down below so you can keep up with all my new uploads. Especially with the holidays, there is so much makeup to be had and talked about. Okay guys, so I basically ended up buying this palette. I caved on the very last day of the VIB sale. I was like, you know what, Karen? It is a face palette. They are so handy. I love them so much because this one in particular has a bronzer that works with my skin tone, a couple of different highlighters, as well as a blush. Now, I actually did pick up the BECCA Christie Teigen palette and ended up returning it because I didn't see myself getting a lot of good use out of it because the bronzer was a little too light for my skin tone and a few different things. If you guys are interested in seeing my review on that palette, I will go ahead and link it up in the cards for you guys. But I felt like this one was gonna be more suitable for my skin tone. My personal problem is I can never get through a highlighter palette. So for example, I've had this BECCA one, the Jaclyn Hill one, for a couple of years, well, ever since it came out. And as you guys can see, I've barely made a dent in this guy. So I was like, Karen, you don't need it. You don't need it. Just don't even think about it. And I felt like these shades are so similar when it comes to like the blushes. And I mean, they're not exactly the same, but you know, it's like, do I really need another one of these colors? They're very, very slightly different, but it's like, oh my gosh, like I can't even get through the one that I have. Why would I want to get more? But like I said, it was the last day of the sale. I totally panicked and I bought it. And then of course, a couple of days later, Black Friday rolls around and the palette goes on sale for $35. So I was pretty pissed off at BECCA about that because here I was paying $43 something for it. Originally the palette retailed for $54. Then I got it for like $43.50 and now it was on sale for $35. I was so mad. I immediately wanted to call Sephora and see if they would price match me, but I just didn't have the time. So I just ordered one for $35. So I'm going to be returning the one I paid more for because that's ridiculous to have paid more than I need to. I hate it when companies do that, when something goes on sale, you know, and it's only been out for a month and a half, maybe, this BECCA palette. I don't even know. So I saw a lot of YouTubers, you know, speak very highly of it, and I didn't have any doubt that it wouldn't be a good palette. It was just, in my mind, me trying to stop being excessive. Now, I feel like if you can get it for $35, it's totally worth it because you get six face products, and granted it's not full size. When are you ever going to get through these products? So 35 divided by 6 is $5.83 is what you're paying for each item, and I think it's well worth it. I've honestly been contemplating getting rid of some of my full-size BECCA highlighters. For example, Opal is already in here, and I'm like, why would I need a full-size Opal if I can just have it in this palette? God knows I'm never gonna get through it. So I am planning a huge sale very soon. I asked for like the IKEA Alex drawers for Christmas, so I'm gonna revamp this room and I'm gonna go through every single piece of makeup and make sure I'm keeping things that I'm only going to use and just get rid of things because I don't want to have a huge ginormous collection that I'm never going to get through. I do have a lot of eyeshadow palettes, but eyeshadow palettes are like my thing. Like I love testing out eyeshadow palettes, but when it comes to like highlights and stuff, I know I'm never going to get through half of it. And I just love my Milani highlighter so much too. I feel like honestly, if all of my other highlighters disappeared and I only had that one, I would be okay. So since I have all these goals in mind for 2018, I'm thinking like, this is going to be great because I can use this on the go. It's also going to be such a good gift now for people that can buy it at the $35 price point. There is no beauty lover that's going to open this after it's under their Christmas tree and be disappointed to have this product. Even me, like, I did not need this, but now that I was able to get it and play with it, I'm so excited. So I just want to cut into a quick demo of me using the product so you guys can see how it applies on my skin tone, and then we'll come back after that and talk a little bit more about the palette. So guys, I thought I always love to demo palettes for you guys, and this BECCA one is new to my collection. So I have some face brushes here. I always start off with the bronzer. So this is the bronzing shade in here, and it is called Bronze Bondi. And I actually have one of these bronzers in a full size, and I really like it. And I think this shade actually works with my skin tone. This is one of the Tarte Holiday brushes as well. So I'm trying it out for the first time for bronzer, and I really like how this is applying, just very diffused. I like to look nice and bronzed in the winter time, even though it's cold out and nobody really expects anyone to be tan in these parts, but I of course love to be tan, and I am tan. So I have this bronzer, or this formula, in a full size, and I do really love it. So I feel like we've got enough bronzer, and now let's move on to blush. So the only blush shade in here is this Winterberry shade, and I personally think it looks very much like the blush in the Jaclyn Hill palette. Now, BECCA blushes are very pigmented, so you really can't go wrong with owning any of them. So that's all I want to do. Just give me like a kiss of color. And then for highlighter, I was really excited for Rose Quartz, so that's what I'm going to use on my skin today. And as you can see, it is very pigmented, so I didn't even really need to put a whole lot on there. Now if you're, oh my gosh, if you're lighter than me, I really don't know how you pull this color off because it's very, very bronzy. Definitely, I feel like BECCA Rose Gold is more rose gold. This is definitely like a rosy, bronzy shade, and I feel like I really need like a drink of hydration because I'm wearing this BECCA foundation and it is so dehydrating. Like, it's like sucked the luminosity out of my skin. So I'm just gonna put some of that spray on just to like hydrate my face, so you guys can imagine what my thoughts are on that foundation. That is my little demo of the BECCA APRES Glow Face Palette. I honestly think if you can get this, you really should. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the demo. It was really quick, but I just wanted to show you guys how these apply. So if I haven't already kind of gone over this stuff, this palette is made in the USA and has a 24-month shelf life. There are 6 shades in here, 1 blush, 1 bronzer, and the rest are highlighters. I guess blush copper is technically considered as a blush, but I used it as a highlight today. I can't really imagine considering that a blush because it's so shimmery. I tend to prefer matte blush shades, and there is a net weight of 0.09 ounces in each of the pans, and the total net weight of this palette is 0.54 ounces. So I am really glad I have this, and I would honestly recommend this to you guys if you're looking at it for personal use, or if you want to pick it up for a friend or family member for Christmas. I think it's a wonderful deal. I am so confused as to why BECCA put it on sale. I feel like I've heard a lot of YouTubers say that, you know, Christmas started so early this year that brands are already trying to put things on sale so they can get rid of things faster. Whereas, you know, in previous years, I feel like the holiday releases come a little bit closer to the holidays. So, you know, let's just use that to our advantage, because I'm not going to lose any sleep over BECCA's, you know, bad decision making. Yeah, I highly recommend this palette, and let me know if you guys are planning on picking this up. I don't really have anything else to say, so I'm gonna end this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you on the next one. Bye.